Buzzer TV presents vintage game shows on Amazon.
Ace is high. Deuce is low. Call it right and win the dough on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you. Hello there. Welcome to Card Sharks. Thank you. Thank you very much. Card Sharks, a game of decisions. We've got a match in progress with two nice ladies, so let's open the board and get to the cards. Janice and Ann, if you will, start loading in the cards. And while they're doing that, we'll meet our Card Sharks. Hello there, Dale. Dale Bozak, our champion.
Hi, how are you today?
Good. You have won $5,100 so
Correct.
Far. Isn't that nice? And again, you do what, Dale?
I do part-time secretarial work for my husband. He's a real estate broker. And I have a little boy that's 4. His name is Justin.
Do you fight with your husband when you're working with him?
Well, he's my worst critic.
Oh, and he's the boss, too.
Yes, I've had other bosses that didn't criticize my typing quite as much as my husband does.
Hey, we welcome back our challenger, Melissa Lacey. Hi, Melissa. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, Jim.
And again, remind us about yourself.
I'm from Upland, California. I'm a student at Cal Poly Pomona. I lifeguard during the summer, and I plan to go to Hawaii this summer.
Good. Well, good luck to both of you. Nice to have you back here with us.
Thank you.
And, of course, the red cards on the top will be played by Gail, our champion. And the lower cards, the blue cards, will be played by Melissa, our challenger. And each player has their own deck of 52 playing cards, shuffled and cut before we go on the air. And as you can see, we have a game in progress. Melissa has two cards turned over, needing just three here. Gail has yet to turn over a card. And the object of the game is to predict whether each of these cards is higher or lower than the one that precedes it, working your way across the board. Before you can play on that board, you have to first answer a high-low toss-up question. They're all based on a poll of 100 people. They test your ability to judge human nature. And as we left off, we are going to the second question, and it goes to you, Melissa. We asked 100 men in California, do you think it's wrong for a married man to have a mistress? How many men thought it was wrong?
California men are pretty liberated, but I would say a low amount would admit to it. I think probably 20.
She says that 20 men out of 100 think it's wrong to have a mistress. Gail, higher or lower?
20 men think that it is wrong to have a mistress?
How many men thought it was wrong? Married men.
20 men think it was wrong. I would say it'd be higher.
You say higher?
Yes.
If it is higher, you go to the board first, Gail. If not, Melissa gets first crack at the cards. The actual number of men who think it's wrong for married men to have a mistress is 57. It's higher. Yeah. Oh, I wonder if their wives were sitting next to them when they made out that poll. No, I don't think so. Gail, we'll take a look at your base card. You won the high-low toss-up question. You have a right to change that base card if you like. You have a 3.
Oh, very nice card. I'll keep it, and I'll say the next card will be higher.
Higher than a 3. Remember, if it's another 3 you lose, it must be higher than a 3. It is
Good card.
Now,
good
Gail,
card.
You can freeze if you'd like, or you can continue calling high-low. But remember, if you make a mistake, you lose all the cards back to your base card, and you give Melissa a free chance at her cards. What's it going to be?
Right. I'll go on, and I'll say the next card will be lower.
Lower than a jack.
Oh, good. I'm going to stay with this and keep going. The next card's going to be higher.
Higher than a 4.
Wonderful. I'm going to freeze on that one.
She'll freeze. We'll move the freeze bar over. Now you need just one card to win while Melissa needs 3. And, of course, you kept Melissa away from those cards. We play the best 2 out of 3, $100 for each game. The winner of the match with $200 goes on to play the money cards where you can win thousands. Gail, we asked 100 New York taxi drivers, has a woman passenger ever made a pass at you? How many taxi drivers said yes?
I'm not too familiar with New York. I'd say 65 said that a woman had made a pass at them.
65?
Right.
What do you think, Melissa?
No way. I think the other way around, maybe, but I think it's a lot lower.
Say lower.
Lower.
Well, the actual number of New York taxi drivers who said a woman passenger made a pass at them is
80.
Oh! It's not lower. Gail.
Wonderful. Let's change that car.
I don't know whether to believe them or not.
Oh.
Change
well,
the car.
You don't have to believe them.
And you can change it. You won the question. You must play this one. It is a jack.
Yes.
Gail, call this card.
Next card will be lower.
If this is lower than a jack, you've got the first game in our best 2 out of 3 match. Lower than a jack? Clear the board, Janice, if you will. Game number one to Gail, $100. Melissa, you got to make a comeback. Feel confident?
Right, yes.
We'll get to the next game of the match right after we take time out for this. Game number one to Gail and $100. And Janice, if you will, deal out the cards for the next game. Same two decks of cards. We just take the ones right off the top. So if you can remember what cards are played, it could help you. Melissa, we'll start with a question for you. We asked 100 women. Now, honestly now, who gossips more, you or your husband? How many women admitted they gossip more?
Women are pretty honest that way. I would think 68.
68. All the men out there were shouting high numbers, the women low numbers. Gail, she says 68 out of 100 women said they gossip more. What do you say, higher or lower?
Boy, I know a lot of women that have a lot to say, and I'll say it'll be higher than that.
Higher than that?
Yes.
Two women with very high numbers. That's interesting. The actual number of women who admitted they gossip more than their husbands is 74. It's higher, Gail. Yeah, we'll look at that base card for this game, which is a 2.
Oh, good. Uh-huh. Beautiful card. The next card will be higher.
Higher than a 2.
Oh, beautiful. Beautiful. Let's go on. The next card will be lower.
Lower than a king.
It's great. I'm going to freeze on that.
You'll freeze. Next question goes to you, Gail. We asked 100 ex-convicts, have you ever had a professional manicure? How many ex-convicts said they have had a professional manicure?
The quality of our convicts is going up. I'll say 20.
20.
Right.
And we didn't say whether it was in or out of prison there, Gail.
Oh, right.
Say 20. Melissa, what do you think, higher or lower?
I don't think the quality of convicts has gone up that much. Lower.
Lower than that. Well, the actual number of ex-convicts who said they have had a manicure is 54, not lower. Gail.
All right, let's change that card.
Change that. I didn't have to get over here before she could change that card. It is a king, a good change.
Beautiful. Yes, the next card will be lower.
Lower than a king.
It's great. I have to go on that. The next card will be higher.
If this is higher than a 4, you have won the match and you go to the money cards. If not, Melissa still has a chance. Higher than a 4 for the win. You did it. Gail, congratulations.
Thank you.
Melissa, thank you for joining us. I hope you had fun.
Oh, I really did. It was great.
Good luck with your study.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Gail, come on down here. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
You've won over $5,000 so far.
I'd like to double that.
Good. I hope she can. With the money cards coming up right after this. Gail, now you've got $5,300 so more. You think that's going to affect your play over there on the money cards?
Definitely. I'm going to bet higher and higher.
Oh, really? It gives you confidence?
Much more. I know I have that much I can take home.
That's in the bank. All right. Let's open the board. I hope she does it. Let's get to the money cards. Okay, Gail. Once again, you won $200 in winning the match. That's yours to keep. Now we're going to give you new money to play with. And this time you're going to bet that money with a brand new deck all shuffled and cut. Start on the bottom line with $200. Bet that as you wish with those three cards. When you move up to the second level, we add another $200 of betting money to bet with these three cards. Now your minimum bets are $50 till you get to that top card, that big bet. And there you must bet at least half the money. All set?
All set.
Good luck. Here's $200. And as always, a choice of two base cards. We start with a 2.
Oh, beautiful card.
All right.
Great start.
You got $200? All of it?
All of it.
Remember, as in the game, if it's another 2, you lose. It must be. You're going higher, of course.
Right, higher
than a 2. $200 higher than a 2. It's a 3.
Oh, and another good card. Another good card.
$400 and a three. What's right. your bet?
All 400, then it will be higher.
Again, the whole
right.
thing. $400 higher than a three. It's a three. $800 now with a 10, Gail.
I'll bet 400 that the next card will be lower.
Betting half of it.
Right.
$400 lower than a 10. It's a seven.
Great.
$1,200 and a seven. Up goes the seven to the next level. We add the other $200. Gail, you have $1,400 and a seven.
I'm not too fond of a seven. I'll bet $200 the next card will be higher.
All right, let's try to improve it. $200 higher than a seven. It's a four. Ooh. That might not be a bad trade, though.
Right.
You lost $200, but you wound up
Good
with a much
card.
Better card. You still have $1,200 and this time a four.
I'm going to bet all of it that it's going to be higher.
All of it.
All of it.
There are no more levels. This
I
is
know.
It. $1,200 on the turn of this card. Higher than a four.
Higher.
$2,400 with a nine.
Oh, nine is only fair. I'll bet 400 the next card is going to be higher.
All right, that's you're going against
Can
the
I
odds.
Can I change that? I'd like to bet half of it that the next card will be higher.
Now, wait, now.
1,200.
You want to go against the odds with it being higher?
Yes, there aren't any face cards up there yet. I want to go half of it that it'll
and
be higher.
Half of it. All right, $1,200. Higher.
Right.
Against the odds with a big bet. Higher? No.
Oh.
No, couldn't do it. All right. You've got the six, though, and you still have good money there, $1,200. You must bet at least $600. You can bet more. You've got $1,200 and a six.
I'm going to bet all of it. It's going to be higher.
Again, all of it.
All of it.
All right. You're a gambler, Gail. You said you were going to gamble, and you are. $1,200 higher than a six.
Please,
let's be there.
Higher.
No!
Oh,
Gail, come on down here. You were gambling.
It was a big chance, but there was a lot of money to be had.
Well, you still got a lot of money, and you're still here. She's got $5,300. We'll be back with a new challenger right after this. Gail, got a little carried away there, right?
Right. That was a hard one to lose. There were no high cards in that one.
No, you had to figure somewhere in there a king or a queen was going to come up, but you never know. That's
I
the
kept
thing.
Figuring, kept hoping.
That's the thing about shuffling the deck. You ready to meet a new opponent?
Very ready, yes.
Ready. Okay. Janice, if you will, deal out the cards. Two brand new decks of cards all shuffled and cut. And while Janice is doing that, we'll meet our next challenger on Card Sharks. Joe Wilson. Hello,
Hello.
Joe.
How
nice
are you?
To see you. Tell us something about yourself, sir.
Well, I presently live in Torrance, California, originally from New Brunswick, New Jersey. I'm a former Major League Baseball player. And
congratulations.
Thank you.
Who did you play with?
The Atlanta Braves.
How long did you play?
I was under contract for 3 years.
You had enough of baseball, or do you miss it?
No, I don't miss it at all. Never look back.
Yeah, that's the only way to feel. Good. Good to have you here with us, Joe.
Thank you.
And good luck. Joe will play the lower cards, the blue cards. Gail, the champion, will play the upper cards, the red cards. As we start with a question to you, Gail. We polled 100 pregnant women. You have a four-year-old, hasn't been that long.
Right.
We asked those 100 pregnant women, were you on the pill when you became pregnant? How many pregnant women said they were?
I think the number would have to be pretty low. I'll say six.
Six. Joe, higher or lower than six pregnant women were on the pill when they got pregnant?
Well, I think the number's going to be higher. Most women now are on the pill, perhaps going off now, but I think the number's going to be higher.
Higher than that. The actual number of pregnant women who were on the pill when they became pregnant is four, not higher. Gail.
Good.
Yeah, you go to the board first, Gail, and we'll look at your base card for this game. You're playing with a queen.
It's a good card. I'll keep it. I'll say the next card will be lower.
Lower than a queen. It's
a
five.
Oh, good, good. I'm going to keep going. I'll say the next card will be higher.
Higher than a five.
Oh, good card. I have to go for this one. The next card will be lower.
Lower than a king. It's a
jack. Oh!
Now a decision to make. Only one more card, but you could lose them all.
I have
Trying right away for the win. Lower than a jack.
Oh, come on.
Ah! You did it. Going right across the board. Wow. Deal out the cards for the next game of the match. Ooh, you couldn't have, if you had gotten them that well up there with the money cards, Gail.
It's my turn.
Joe, you're not losing confidence, I hope.
Oh, no, always confident.
Okay, good. That's the way to feel. Gail leads 1-0, $100. Joe, you need this game. Janice is dealing out the cards for the next game. Same decks. And Joe, we asked 100 men in a previous studio audience, have you ever tried to get a woman drunk so you could take advantage of her? How many men admitted that they had tried?
Oh, my goodness. Doesn't go to 200.
No. No.
I'm going to say that quite a few men have. I'm going to say 60.
60?
60 men have.
You were on the road a lot playing baseball, Joe. Did you ever try that?
No, not me.
No, not me. Are you a married man, Joe?
Divorced.
Divorced, okay. I just wondered if you were just taking care of business here. Gail, Joe says 60 out of 100 men have tried to get a woman drunk to take advantage of her. Higher or lower?
That's a hard number to work with, but I'll say it'll be higher.
Say higher than
yes.
That?
Yes.
The actual number of rotten cats
right.
who have tried to get a woman drunk to take advantage of her is 48. Oh. Not higher, Joe. You got it. Joe, let's see if you can have the same kind of luck at the board as we look at your base card. A 2.
Got to go for it. Definitely higher. Next card will be definitely higher.
Higher than a 2. It's a
right.
4.
Okay.
Low, but still another
we'll
good
continue.
Card.
Next card higher.
Higher than a 4 as he continues. It All is
right.
an ace.
We'll still go, and the next card is going to be definitely lower.
Lower than an ace. It is a jack.
Oh, yes.
Now,
gotta go all the way. Gonna be lower than a jack.
You're gonna try to duplicate it.
Gotta try it.
Risking all of those cards. This will tie up the match
on,
if this is lower than a jack.
All right.
He did it. Just like Gail did. Clear the board, Janice. And we will go on to the tiebreaker. Two fast games in a row. Gail with one game and $100. Joe with one game and $100. The tiebreaker, just 3 questions. And as they move the board over, we will be having just 3 cards up there for the tiebreaker. Gail, we start with a question to you. And control, of course, is very important in the tiebreaker. We surveyed 100 women on the beach in Malibu, California. How many of them were wearing bikinis?
Oh, boy. None. I think some people out there think they wear pants. I'll say 80 were wearing bikinis.
80. You think that's the most popular now, the bikini,
right.
huh?
She says nothing.
Or nothing. She says 80 out of 100 were wearing bikinis, Joe. Higher or lower?
Well, Malibu is a pretty permissive area. I'm gonna guess it's gonna be higher.
Even higher.
Higher.
All right. I'd like to go down there and see that. The actual number of women wearing bikinis is 78, not higher. Gail. Gail, we're looking at an all-important base card here in the tiebreaker. It is an 8.
You I'd can like change to change it. That. Thank you.
This one you've got to play. This is a 3.
Oh, good card. Good card. I'll say the next card will be higher.
Higher than a 3. It is a 7.
Ooh,
kind of a middle card there.
Hard decision. I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze, needing
yes.
1 card. Joe has to get control, and he needs 2. The next question, and this time we ask the question of, as Gail needs the 1 card and Joe needs 2, Joe, we ask 100 men, do you have a pot belly? How many men said they did?
Said they did not?
How many? Did.
Did.
Did. How many men did have a pot belly?
Well, I'm sorry. Is it California men or just men in general?
Just 100 men in general.
Just 100 men in general. Okay. I'm going to say that 70 men said they did.
Say 70. If 70. It had been California men, would you have said higher or lower? Then?
I would have said lower because
California. Oh, lower. You figure they're in better shape. All right.
Quick.
He says 70 out of 100 said they had a pot belly. Gail, higher or lower?
Oh, it's another hard number to work with. I'm going to say lower. 70's a pretty high
say
number.
Lower. The actual number of men who had a pot belly is 41.
Oh! Good. Let's change that card.
Changing the 7, and it is a 9. Gail, this is it. We have a tie at 1-1. Call this card.
The next card's going to be lower.
If this is lower, you remain the champion. If not, Joe is still in it. For the win, lower than a 9.
Come on.
It's another 9. It is not lower. That's a break for Joe. And we'll look at your base card, Joe. You have a 3.
Definitely higher.
Higher than a 3.
Definitely higher.
It is a 5.
All the way higher.
If this is higher, we have a new champion. Higher than a 5.
All right.
It's 7. We did it. A new champion. Joe, congratulations. Great comeback. Gail, thank you. You've got $5,400.
Not too shabby.
Not too shabby.
Right.
Thanks for being here. Gail,
thank you an awful lot.
Joe, come on down here with me. Congratulations. We'll take a quick break and we'll be right back with the money cards right after this. We'll play the money cards next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
One of our polling groups will receive Gibson's microwave oven with digital timer, defrost setting, solid-state variable power control, and Tempo Sensor cooking probe. Gives you dependable, cool, clean, fast-paced cooking furnished by Gibson. And some of our contestants will receive the Hamilton Beach Mini Drip Coffee and Tea Maker. Brews 2 to 4 cups in minutes. Fresh hot coffee only when you want it. Eliminates waste. Hamilton Beach Scoville. And the Jovan collection of aftershave cologne. Exciting musk oil, mysterious ginseng, provocative sex appeal, and elegant Monsieur Jovan wear them all. And West Clocks looks ahead in time. The smartly styled, compact, Big Ben solid-state LED digital AM-FM instant-on clock radio from West Clocks by Tally Industries, and a 2-test waffle baker and grill from True Value Hardware Stores, who combine value and personal service in over 5,000 locations nationwide. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.